feed another person when he is hungry. I have a right to help others. That is duty. I must have freedom for that, to help others. But we should not have freedom to rupture the society. If a fellow wants to do whatever he likes to do, he is a traitor. He is not a patriot. He is a traitor. So indisciplined citizen always becomes a traitor. So nobody is curbing. Who is curbing you or freedom? The police asked. They said, you are curbing, oh police, you are curbing our freedom. For what? We are for the safety and the welfare of the people. You are curbing our independence. The rebels, wrong slogans. Nowadays, slogans, you don't think otherwise. I will give an example. The United States of America creates number of troubles among the inhabitants of country to country, right? But what they do? They have attacked Iraq. They got the, what is his name? What is his name? Yeah, Iraq's president, whatever. I don't remember. Iraq. Yes, Hussein was killed. The US has encouraged rebellion against that fellow. They want to have their self-interest to be fulfilled. For that sake, they create infights in the country, other countries. And they become the champions of one group and fight against another group. Unless the US or some other country, or Britain or some other country, intrude into the affair of a country, but country is at peace. If any country is not peaceful, it is due to the cause of the intrusion of the foreign agencies. They come and they disrupt firstly unity, then our culture, our beautiful culture. Every country has its own culture. All the cultures of the ancient nations are alike. They are one. The Indian culture, the Chinese culture, the Hebrew culture, the Greek culture, the Romans, Chaldeans, Babylonians, all the cultures are alike. They are similar to each other. But wherever the English people or American people put up their finger in the country, they destroy the native cultures, right? Know it? Is it the same what is happening here? So you are not for the safety of the people. You, under the banner of safety of the people, you are causing destruction to the safety of the people, the police said. Now, Lord Krishna has ordained us, let the public be the judges. You are the rebels. You are not patriots. Now the public will decide what type of punishment is to be given to you, the police said. That is very good. Public decides. That is the verdict of Lord Krishna. There are shouts from the crowd. Then, 30 people, shield their chair innocence. The rebels are innocents. Some people used to say. They said, these people are very innocent. They are not to be punished. It was a big confusion. Who are these 30 people? Can you tell me? Some 10 rebels were being arrested by the police, imprisoned by the police. Suddenly, about 30 people from the crowd, masses, came forth and crying, they are innocents, unnecessarily and unjustly, they are being imprisoned. Who are these? They are their friends. They are also rebels. Some rebels, some traitors, destroy the society, disrupt the peace of the society, and some traitors join the mob, join the natives of the land, and come to support them. In our country also is happening like that. You know, we have some revolutionaries. They kill persons, rich persons. They say they bring about a revolution against the rich and they would establish the welfare of the poor. But it is wrong. It's not that what they are doing. They kill any man. If somebody opposes, he says, it's my freedom. Suppose a policeman or two or three policemen kill a rebel fellow, what happens? Some among the people cry, shout, you have done injustice. You have unnecessarily killed the revolutionary. They are very good. They are for our safety. But see the state of affairs in our country. There is an association by name Civic Rights Association. You have it in your countries? Civic Rights Association. It's not actually they are fighting for civic rights. They are not fighting for the rights of all the people. They are fighting for the rights of the destroyers, the disruptors. Those 30 people who are crying, they are innocent. They should not be punished. War, they differ from complexion, from color, and from body structure from the natives. They are not natives. They are also foreigners. One group rebel, one group supports. That is the fashion. They were shot. They were not like the natives of the line. One of the police officers addressed the bigger crowd, the public in general. I hope you are the true residents of the city. You come forward and decide what punishment should be given to them. He is appealing to the mass. Are he asking the mass, can you identify these 30 people? Are these people your relations, your friends, your natives or foreigners? You decide. Can you identify them? The police asked. Nobody came forth. That is the fashion. Nobody has the courage to tell the truth. Everybody is afraid of the rebellions. Oh, if I say truth against them, tomorrow they will kill me. That is the position. From the state of affairs, when this novel story happened, now the state of affairs has grown worse. In those days, at least policemen were truthful, sincere, and they were catching hold of the traitors. But nowadays, the policemen also are joining hands and hands with the culprits. Now the position is far worse. There is a proverb in India, a policeman is a licensed thief. A policeman is a licensed thief. A thief is not licensed to do stealing. A policeman can steal with a license. Such is the position now. In those days, different. Suppose the policeman have relations with the thieves. The thieves steal money or steal some furniture from our house. And a part of the furniture, a part of the goods, a part of the money they steal is being distributed among the police and the criminals. Generally, there may be exceptional police figures, they are very truthful, but generally this is the most part. The police never keep peace, never seek for the rights of the people. They seek for the rights of the criminals who oppress the people. The police and the criminals are now inseparable. But in those days, when Lord Krishna ruled, the policemen were sincere at least. They asked his mob, you come forward, identify who are crying this. One of them replied, these people are not so bold to announce that we have no relationship with them, they are foreigners. But the rebels said, we are not the citizens of the city. We are living 100 miles away from this city. The only relationship with these people, we have to put justice. We want justice for these people. The tamasha is, a Britisher comes to us, I want justice for India. What is the fun of it? An American comes, a Russian comes, or some other country fellow comes, I want justice for Germany. Is it right? The Germans must put forth the effort for the peace. It's not the Americans. But they announce under the name of democracy. He says, Saddam Hussein is the dictator. We fight for democracy. Therefore, let us kill him. Some under the name of democracy, they are encouraging Pakistan against India. Under the name of democracy, they are supporting fascism. The so-called Democrats are supporting fascism. They want infight between our two countries, always. To one country they give money, to other lend money, to other country they give arms. They want infight between these two countries. They say, it's for your own justice, for your own benefit we have come here. You know, in Vietnam, in Korea, so many thousands of American army were landed there. In other countries, if you ask what for, we are for the peace of this country. That is fun, great fun. It is our duty to protect the principles and rights of the people. It is not your duty, it is the duty of the police, it is duty of the mob. You are not, you have no guts to fight for rights. You are fighting for your rights, not for the rights of the people. Then the police said, the public is in no way responsible for you. You are disrupting the society. You are disturbing citizens of Dwaraka. In 3 minutes, they said to the mob, the police said, in 3 minutes we will catch hold of all the rebels, all those who supported rebels. In 3 minutes we will catch them. Are you ready? They asked the mass. Immediately, these 30 people, 30 rebels, they ran away. Some police, in the garb of the subjects, in the garb of general people, they picked them, they caught hold of them again and put them in prison. That is the story. This type of story is occurring today also.